The fumes given off when soldering are not something you want to be breathing in, as they are toxic and can lead to irritation and even asthma if inhaled regularly. This is why it's important to always solder in a well-ventilated environment. One of the ways you can do this is by using a fume extractor, which is what we're going to be building in this video. This one is super cheap and quick to build, and is definitely worth making if you ever solder. To build it, we'll need two 120mm computer fans and accompanying screws, a DC jack and some wire, some flexible ducting, various cardboard pieces, sticky back Velcro, and a cardboard shoebox. We'll also need these tools. The first thing we can do is solder the two power wires of the fans in parallel and extend them out to the DC jack. We'll now mark out two 115mm holes for the fans on the side of the shoebox using a compass and then cut them out using a knife. We're going to be mounting the fans on the inside of these holes using screws, so we need to use a small crosshead screwdriver to first mark the hole points of the fans and then punch right through afterwards. We can now thread the fan screws into these holes and then screw the fans in place. I was surprised at how rigid and strong the front became after they were screwed in. Now we can make a hole for the DC jack at the back of the box and use some glue to stick it in place. So the next step is to cut out a square in the side of the box and trim down a piece of cardboard to fit over it. Now we can mark out a circle on this cardboard that's just slightly smaller than the diameter of the ducting, and use a stapler to attach the two together. Now it's just a case of adding some Velcro to the box and the cardboard cutout. To make a good seal, we can also add some thin strips of sponge, which should stop any air from being blown through the gap. Whilst we're at it, we might as well seal all the edges of the box with some duct tape as well. Now, the problem with using flexible ducting is that it's quite hard to store, and you know, it's a bit like a giant spaghetti. So what we can do is add some more Velcro to the other side of the removable cardboard cutout. Now when we want to pack it away, it's just a case of putting the ducting inside the box and pressing the panel down onto the Velcro. The last thing to add is a shroud around the fans to help direct the airflow. To do this, it's just a case of sticking on some more cardboard cutouts to the front edges using some duct tape so that they can be folded inwards. To complete the shroud, we can add a trapezoid cutout to the top. Now we can add some small Velcro pads to the new shroud so that it will be held in place once folded away. And we're done! So let's give it a test. So we'll shove the ducting out of a window and plug a 12V DC power adapter into the jack at the back. As you can see, the fumes get successfully extracted, making soldering an altogether safer experience. To help with visibility, I added a strip of LEDs to the roof of the hood. They're just connected in parallel with the fans, as they too operate off 12V. As I mentioned earlier, it can be quickly packed away when not in use, making this build particularly practical for home use. If you want to use it during winter without having a window open, you can replace the ducting with carbon filter, which traps the harmful fumes rather than exhausting them outside. So, thanks for watching! I hope I see you in my next video, where I'll be showing you my homemade computer case, which has an entirely custom layout and a quite exciting cooling solution, particularly for the graphics card. Bye for now!